Yeah.
You can send it back.
Oh, darling, no one would take that back once they got rid of it.
You can send them all back. The wedding's off.
Kay, what are you saying?
Just that. I'm not going to marry Buckley. I found out something about him that's unforgivable.
What could have happened?
I don't know. Ellie, let me go.
Please, Pops. It's no use talking.
I'm not gonna talk, honey. I just wanted to tell you everything's all right. Whatever you choose to do, it's okay with us, you know.
Thank you, Pops.
You always used to talk about taking a little trip to Europe, you know. Now, why don't I fix that up tomorrow? You could take one of your friends with you. And...
Oh, Pops, I couldn't. Not after all you've been through. All this horrible expense and everything.
Oh, heavens, that doesn't matter. Nothing matters except your happiness. What? Well, we can arrange everything. We'll make some excuse, say that you're ill or something. Send back the presents, notify the people who are coming. Don't.
Oh, he should have told me before. He shouldn't have kept it from me. He had this thing come out of the blue tonight.
There. Don't.
Nova Scotia for a honeymoon. A camp in Nova Scotia. So he could fish for some horrible salmon or something. He knew I'd bought millions of evening clothes and things. That didn't matter to him. Oh, no. He loves to go fishing, so he decides we're going fishing.
Well, after all...
What do you mean?
I thought it was something even worse than that. You know, maybe like another girl or...
Oh, a girl wouldn't be so bad. At least you could get your teeth in a girl. But this is our whole lives, our whole future. If he sees us this selfish now, so mean when it's a question of our honeymoon, what's he going to be like after we're married?
Had you talked it over?
Of course we had. I told him I wanted to go someplace romantic. But he said there was nothing as romantic as a fishing shack in Nova Scotia. We had a horrible fight. I said terrible things to him. And he called me a spoiled brat. I made him stop the car and I jumped out and left him right there.
Buckley's here. Poor boy's stricken. He looks terrible.
Will you see him?
No.
I never saw anyone who was suffering so.
He'll get over it.
Good evening, sir.
Won't see you, Buckley.
If I could just speak to her.
Right, it's
just...
no use, son.
Well, you're telling her I'm sorry. She's right about the whole thing. I was selfish and pig-headed. I didn't realize I should have asked her. I'll go anywhere. I'll do anything. Yeah. Just tell her that I'm sorry. Yes. I'll give anything to take back what I said. Yeah. Will you tell her that?
Yes,
please?
I'll tell her. Go on home now. Pull yourself together.
Thank you, sir.
What did you do to your
hand? Nothing.
What have you done to her?
Hey, slam the car door on it.
Well, let's get some,
Buckley! Oh, darling! Darling, I'm sorry.
No, it was my fault. Forgive me.
Oh, no, it wasn't your fault.
I was selfish and pig-headed.
Oh, darling,
I'm sorry.
Oh, it's all right. Oh, I did act like his poor brother.
Go anywhere you want to go anymore. It's all right.
Oh, darling, does it hurt?
No.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No.
It doesn't matter just as long as
anywhere you want to go.
Oh, I'm sorry.